السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام mentioned in a hadith reported by in the book of Abi Dawood and Ibn Majah. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, "من لزم الاستغفار جعل الله له من كل ضيق مخرجا ومن كل هم فرجا ورزقه من حيث لا يحتسب." Look at this beautiful hadith. That is, you know, where the Prophet ﷺ is giving us glad tidings. Prophet ﷺ, in this hadith, is mentioning that the one who is constantly seeking forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, he's constantly making istighfar, astaghfirullah al-azim, in different shapes and forms of istighfar. He is constantly seeking Allah's forgiveness. Therefore, the Prophet ﷺ mentions three things that Allah will give him. Three things. First, جعل الله من كل ضيق مخرجا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will free him from all difficult situations that he finds himself in. Secondly, Allah subhanahu جعل الله من كل ضيق مخرجا ومن كل هم فرجا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will free him from all worries. All the worries that are in his heart that he's worried about day and night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through istighfar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove this from his heart. And finally, وَرَزَقَهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. He will free him, he will provide him from where he never expected from. So subhanAllah, brothers and sisters, look at the situation today people find themselves in. They find themselves, you know, confined to their own home. They find themselves, you know, in difficult financial situation. And the Prophet ﷺ here, you know, he's telling us that through istighfar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide you those three things. How difficult it is to sit down and make istighfar and seek Allah's forgiveness. You know, it will take maybe 5 to 10 minutes to make istighfar, you know, for 100 times, 200 times. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for sure, if we're sincere and we do it with regret, because we all sin, we all commit sins. So if we seek Allah's forgiveness with the feeling of that we are regretful of our sins, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala surely will forgive our sins along with those three things the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told us about. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.